गुड इवनिंग। दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो अबाउट द एम एस एक्सेल एज एज वी आर कंडक्टिंग 15 डेज सर्टिफिकेट कोर्स ऑन कंप्लीट एम एस ऑफिस इंक्लूडिंग द एम एस वर्ड, एम एस एक्सेल एंड द एम एस पावर पॉइंट। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। एज यू कैन सी ऑन यूर स्क्रीन, दिस इज द एम एस एक्सेल। एम एस एक्सेल इज द पार्ट ऑफ द एम एस ऑफिस। सो हाउ यू कैन ओपन इट, देर आर टू मेथड्स टू ओपन इट। वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द बेसिक पॉइंट। द फर्स्ट, you click on the icon if icon is available on your screen. Otherwise, you go on the start button and check your all this, you know, softwares. Alphabetically, you come on the M because MS, it is the part of the MS Office. This is the M, this Microsoft Office. Click on the Microsoft Office. This is, see, this is the Microsoft Office Excel 2007. So we have to click on this one. I already opened it, so no need to click from my end. So this is the toolbar. You can see some of the parts will be same in MS Word, Excel and the power. Some part will be the same in both three, Excel, Word and PPT. Home. So first of all, we discuss about the home. Click on the home button. This is the new. What is the use of it? New. If you suppose you are working on this cell, you are working on this one. And after that, you want to open one more cell, the new refresh cell. So for that, we have to click on the new button. So this, go here, new. So new sheet will open out. This is the one thing. The second thing, you can see on the bottom of the screen, sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. This is the benefit of the MS Excel. You can work, suppose there are four sections, you as working as a teacher. So sheet 1 is, you can take it for section 1, sheet 2 for section 3 and sheet 3 for section 4, section C, and you can increase the sheets also. And you can give the name as per your requirements. Go on the right button, rename. You give the name section A. So now it will be section A. It make your work very easy. You can change the name of sheet 2 also. Go on that one, click right click and then rename it. So it is easy. Let us come on next one, the open. If you would like to open any of the MS Excel already prepared by you and saved in your laptop or the computer, I click on the this button, open. So all worksheets will come out here. Suppose I would like to open this bank details, so I select it and I click on the open button. What will happen? This particular document, MS Excel document, will open here. The next one is the save. After completing your task, suppose I done my job, until unless you will not type even single button, it will not saved out. So first of all, I have to write down something, and after that I go on the save button and I saved it. When you click on the save button, it's actually already saved with the name of the wellness. Otherwise, if it's a new, suppose we work on a new sheet, this is the new sheet, and suppose we are working on it. Now we click on the save button. It asks us where we actually would like to save it, on which position, desktop, documents, download, C drive, D drive, where, or any folder. Suppose I would like to save it on the desktop, and on desktop I want it in folder 11th class. So click open the folder. And now I don't want to save it book 2. I would like to save it as a name of the wellness 2. Save. So what will happen? This is just saved out. Go on the desktop and the folder. What was the name of the folder? 11th class. Click on the 11th class. Here wellness 2, this is the wellness 2. So it saved here.
this is the location of this particular document. So let us come back. Next is the save as. As we discussed in the last video when we were talking about the MS Word, save as. Save is the simple, you can save, and save as give you many other options. I am working on MS Excel 2007. If you would like to save it in the old version, the 97 Excel or the 2007 Excel sheet, so the option is also here, this one. If you would like to save it as a spreadsheet, you can do that. If you want to save this wellness 2 documents in the form of the PDF, you can do. The next one is, if you would like to save in another format other than the PDF or XPS, so go on the other formats. A new box will open. Select in which form you would like to save it. Lot of options are here: Excel workbook, Excel macro, Excel binary workbook, and JPG. JPG, PDF, XPS document, text, MS Docs. Lot of options are here. So as per your requirement, you can save it. If you would like to save in the single form, you can do with the help of save. If you would like to save it as a PDF, so go on the save as, select this button and click on it. So this is about the saves as, and the formulas of cut, copy, paste are same. For the cut, you have to use Control X. This is Control X. I just write here Control plus X for, this is for the cut. If you would like to cut any of the content, and Control C for the copy, it's for the copy. Copy your content, and for the paste, it will be there Control V. This is for the paste. So either you go for, you select, you choose the options cut and paste or copy and paste. So cut and paste means cut. If you select the cut and paste, your content will come on the new position, but delete from the last one. But in case of the copy and paste, it will come on the next position and it will be on the old position also. So that is the difference between the cut and the copy. Next is, you can see on your screen, this button is the Calibri. You can see, you can select any of the format of your content. So this is my content, select it. I just select this content, I go on this button, I just write it here, go here, see, it's changed the format, fonts, theme fonts. So which one is suitable for you, you select that. And the size also, 11, right now it's 11 by default, you can select anyone. 24, this is the 24 size. One more thing, now you can see this CLTR, R is not clear, it came under the line. So how to increase the size, or how to pull out this line, this cell, just go on the cell at here and give the double click. Double click at here, the right side of a particular cell, go on the right side line, not on the left side line. If you would like to explore the I related cell, so not on the starting, at the end of this one, and give the double click, so it will come as per the size. This one is the same A and largest A and the smallest A. the largest A, if you click again and again on this one, your font size will increase again and again. And the same vice versa, the A, small A is for the, if you would like to decrease the size of your content, the your written content, you again and again click on the smallest A button. B, I and U are the same. B for the bold, I for the italic, and U for the underline. So the short keys about these three are, for the bold, it is Control B. For the bold, if you would like to bold your content, C, Control plus I is for the italic. For the italic the content, and Control plus U is for the underline the content. If you would like to put your content under underline, if you convert it into the underline, Control U. Either you go with the help of this toolbar, you select your content and click suppose on the click on the U. Now it's underlined. Either you use this toolbar or you can use your keyboard. So both options are here. The same the alignment. These are the alignments. The right side, the left side, and the center. Center of the cell. The left side of the cell and the right side of the cell. This is the upward of the cell, the center of the cell, and downward of the cell. And this is about the colors, the font color and the cell color. This is for the cell color. It will fill our complete cell. This is for the font color. Suppose we select the red, so our font will convert into the red color. So these are the basic keys about or the functions about the MS Excel. It's enough for this video. Thank you.